morning, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues. In the beginning, I would like to thank organizing committee and Mr. Tavares, who enabled us to present our technology, seawater steam engine. Our lecture consists of three parts. In the first part, I will talk about introduction to seawater steam engine and consequences of climate change until today. In the second part, Professor Glasnovic will be talk about proposal of new climate policy, climate new deal, and nine characteristics of seawater steam engine technology. In the third part, I will talk about what we have created, and I will talk about of seawater steam engine. Our technology described in book presented in publishing in 2017, and its presentation predict the 10 years research, and we published also 28 scientific papers and more than 30 papers, other 30 papers. We have presented published 5 book chapters and 4 patents, 3 international patents and 1 European patent. What is seawater steam engine technology? Seawater steam engine technology is radically new technology, and it is a scientific and technological breakthrough. This technology can simultaneously and continuously produce energy and drinking water using only 3 natural forces: renewable energy sources, seawater, and gravity. What are consumers' benefits? Our technology gives the possibility that settlement or cities from intermittent renewable energy sources give at any time the necessary power and necessary energy and drinking water. And this technology gives the continuous energy and drinking water supply throughout the year. Thank you. Consumers completely independent of external sources of energy and drinking water. I will give a few notes then why new technology. This technology can be made at today's level of technological development. This technology would be equally accessible to both development of and less developed countries. It is possible to contribute a common goal stopping climate change. Reduce consumption of fossil fuels, reduce emission of gases which have strong effects on global warming, CO2 and other greenhouse gases, give positive steps to restore of natural balance and drinking water supply. We believe that this technology is a human solution, and we know that in the past wars were due to energy supplies, but in the future wars will be due to lack of drinking water. During the fact, there are many changes around us. Can we continue to argue that climate change is a lie? We have a consensus of 97% of scientists that humans are causing global warming. Only 3% of scientists are skeptics. What are the indicators of climate changes? I will talk about some indicators. Our focus are in CO2, but in the nature have another greenhouse gases. In what is happened in the atmosphere and what is happening in the oceans. In the oceans, we have a situation that the dissolution and evaporation of CO2 is equilibrium. Oh, sorry. It's equilibrium process. Wind and waves helps to dissolve CO2 in the mixed layers. From mixed layers, CO2 bring in the deeper layer in oceans. And what happens if the increase of sea surface temperature? With increased sea surface temperature, concentration of CO2 in the atmosphere is decreased. And if in the future, if sea surface temperature of ocean is in decrease, in the atmosphere have a doubled concentration of atmospheric CO2. If the natural processes are disturbed, we have consequences of flora and fauna and in the oceans, as well as in the environment and humans. That is another problem. Problem with concentration CO2 in atmosphere, then still rising, and problem with decrease of pH value in the oceans. The change of 0.1 in the pH value is small, but this changes change with happen about 5,000 to 10,000 years in the past. The last measurement concentration of CO2 was 410 parts per million. Similar changes occurred in the past, but I said. Okay, many studies show that increase of sea water level rise in temperature. If we compare the climate changes with Pisa Tower, moving of Pisa Tower, we conclude that these changes is small, but if we do not something to stop it, we will come to breaking point, which there is not going back. We are witnesses that are many changes in the past few months. Hurricanes formed on the ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Middle East, Japan, and we have problem if this hurricane come together in one big hurricane. And the temperature of the eye of this big hurricane is -18.3 degrees Celsius. And the final of the first part of our presentation, I will show you the movie. After this big hurricane, have a new eyes will be, and we must be aware that this will happen and if something is will not done. I finish the first part and Professor Lastmić talk about the second part.
We didn't see what will be with climate changes. The colleagues, Dr. Carlo Vargeta, want to show that these changes will be slow. Problem is that she wants to show that these changes will be sudden. That's the reason. And what's the reaction on these suddenly climate changes? Because people don't understand that these changes will be immediate, will be suddenly. And what's typical reaction? Typical reaction on suddenly climate changes is at first panic. We can panic. Second reaction is normal reaction that as clever bird as ostrich who put it out here in the sand. And many people don't want to accept that climate changes will be so strong and so terrible for mankind. And third reaction is reaction what we choose, reaction to act or do something or try to solve the problem. What we have up to now, let's see what United Nations offer up to now. Sorry. Up to now, we have 1992, this International Environmental Treaty, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. And they get us to protocols, Kyoto Protocol and Paris Agreement. But for Kyoto Protocol, many people think that we don't succeed with this protocol. These protocols not succeed, we think that's failed. The successor of this protocol is Paris Agreement. Now we have Paris Agreement. What will be with Paris Agreement, I will show later. But what the United Nations work up to now? They have conference of parties from 1995. There are COP1, the last was finished those days, COP23 in Bonn. We know. They produce many papers, many reports, many documents, etc., etc., etc. But what's results? I don't know what's results. We don't know. We think that they haven't results because global temperature, planet's temperature is still rising. They haven't results. In last conference in Bonn, they said that they will adapt on this. They didn't get any solution for this. Last data, what we have from last year up to now, show that the increasing in climate, in the carbon dioxide, is about 2%. 2% carbon dioxide. Consequences is global temperature also will rise. So, let's know what the Paris Agreement offered to us. Everybody today speaks about Paris Agreement. We must this agreement to realize, etc., 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 etc. But state or main objective of Paris Agreement is to limit the increase in the global average temperature to well below 2 Celsius degree above pre-industrial level. So main objective is to limit it global temperature. Let me see what's defined, what's causes and what's consequences. What's causes of global warming? Causes is, as you see, I don't know, causes, what's causes? Causes is economy. Mankind couldn't be without economy. Economy based on fossil fuels. So we can call this economy high carbon economy. Now today we have high carbon economy. This is causes. What's consequences?
consequences are global warming. We have rising of temperature, global temperature. We have causes, we have consequences. Paris Agreement want to act on consequences. It is impossible. It is impossible. We have any regulator, any thermostat to turn off global economy. It's impossible. Paris Agreement is impossible because they focused on consequences. On this agreement want to say consequences. But problem is in causes. As we have this thermostat, we couldn't act on consequences. And I must say from this stage to whole world, Paris Agreement is wrong. It is impossible to realize. It is impossible because we couldn't turn off this economy. That's the reason that we write that climate system is not to boil, which we will heat it by 2 Celsius degree after which we could turn off the world economy. It is impossible. Problem is in causes. So, where are we now? Now we are in the sandwich between causes and between consequences. How to solve problem? It seems that there are no solution, but we find solution. There are only one exit, only narrow passage, but we can solve this problem. Tunnel. In the end of this tunnel is light. But what is exit? What is solution? We must change high carbon economy in green economy. But keywords is reorientation. Because there are many jobs. Nobody wants to lose jobs in high carbon economy, today's economies. That's the problem. We couldn't turn off immediately. But we can make transition or reorientation from high carbon economy to green economy. Okay, so we think that world must get new policy, state new policy. We prepare for the conference this policy. We analyze this case, and what will be new policy? How to set new objectives? In Kyoto Protocol, we have limitation of green gases emission. In Paris Agreement, is limitation of global temperature. But the same things, the same, very similar things, because carbon dioxide is causes for global temperature. But the same things in another way, set in another way. We could all, in Kyoto Protocol, green gases emission and global temperature are called consequences. But we couldn't act on consequences. So, only one way to solve global problem and stop immediately, suddenly climate changes is first reorientation. Reorientation from high carbon economy to green economy. This reorientation can be recalculated. It's random number. 2% of GDP for developed countries and 1% of GDP for less developed countries. I'll explain later what mean this. So, reorientation is first objective. Second objective, we need strong technology. We need strong technology, radically new technology, which can produce, simultaneously produce energy and drinking water. It's not enough to have energy, because problem is drinking water also. So we need radically new technology with great potential for further development. It is also important, because we couldn't get solution to this. This technology must have great potential for further development. And third is that, as soon as possible, as short as possible.
But 30 years will be period what we calculated that will be
enough.
And we prepared for this conference, and we, I said, without the Paris Agreement realization, the aesthetic dependence of immediate sudden climate change brings, we want to propose that first we discuss about this new policy, what we called Climate New Deal, because it's new relationship between countries, developed and less developed countries. After that, if we reach some this consensus of this conference, we will sign it. This consensus, who wants to sign, and after that, kindly request organizer, Dr. Tavivara, organizer, to propose the new agreement to the United Nations Secretariat as amendment to International Environmental Treaty, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Because we think that this is solution, not what they said in Bonn adaptation to climate changes. What means adaptation? They recognize that they don't succeed. Adaptation is not solution. We must fight if you want fight from against climate changes. So we have proposal. We offer solution to them. We are scientists. We want to solve problem. We must solve problem. As we know, this is reason that we want that we find some new policy who will be proactive policy who will solve this problem of climate change. Okay, what means reorientation? Nobody wants to lose these jobs and in high carbon economy, and we said, okay, you will not lose jobs, and you can invest, every country invest 1% from GDP. We calculated this percent in our paper, 2010, Vision of Total Renewable Electricity Scenario, what we published. 1% is enough for reorientation from high carbon economy to green economy. This is term, explanation of term, what means reorientation. But there are problems between developed and less developed countries. And we need to find agreement between this group of countries. This agreement needs also that developed countries help to less developed countries shape with 1% of GDP. This reason that developed country can pay 2% of GDP, but less developed country only 1%. There is some metaphor. Pisa Tower is a metaphor. Why this metaphor? A friend of mine before some months said me that you couldn't stop climate change. It's not a car that you break and stop this system. It's a big system. It is impossible. How do you mean to stop climate changes? I think about this opinion, and I said, okay, we'll make metaphor. Metaphor will be with Pisa Tower inclined or tilted 1 millimeter per year, and if we don't repair this Pisa Tower, they will be collapsed. Climate system is same things for climate system. It's quite wrong opinion thinking that climate system will be heating, we will greater temperature 2, 4, 5, or 400 years, etc., sea level rising, etc. It's not this that we couldn't understand in this way. Pisa Tower couldn't slow down up to down. It will collapse. Climate system will be collapsed. They couldn't accept so many carbon dioxide. They couldn't accept We don't know. Dr. Carmen Margaret has said that he thinks it's one. We don't know. It can be for 1 year, for 10, 20, 50 years. We don't know. But we know that climate change is present. We know this problem. The Pisa Tower is repaired in 10 years. How they extract sand in opposite side of the inclination, opposite side, and we have repaired only corrected for 45 centimeter. It's enough because our inclination is 4 meters. 45 centimeters in 10 years slowly repair. We think this climate system can slowly repair, but we have time, but slowly in 30 years to extract or not emitted 36 gigatons per year, less and less and less, and in same time, in same way to repair climate system or keep in today's global temperature. That's metaphor. So we need new strategy. How we can do it? This is dynamic of this strategy. This strategy could be real. What we have asked about in 8 years, it's not occasionally, it's not random. 8 years, because solar cycle is about 8 to 10 years. And there's 30 years. Now we are about in global temperature plus 1 Celsius degree. And what is green line? Green line is built new technology. Not only CO2 just imagine, but this technology is in our title is the most powerful technology, and with logistic curve, we will rise this system up to production, total world electricity production, about 24,000 terawatts of energy. This is total world consumption today. If we achieve this rising of new technology, in this way we will save or reduce 20 gigawatts of carbon dioxide with this, only with this technology. But other technology also will be built. This is space for you, for energy efficiency, for other new energies and other technology, because it's very, very big emission, 36 gigatons. If we achieve this rising of new technology and other technology, we'll have decreasing of carbon dioxide emission from 36 gigatons up to zero, up near. In this way, global temperature, today we are in 1 Celsius degree. If we stop today's from high carbon economy, if we turn of this economy. Climate system has inertia. They couldn't stop global warming, couldn't stop immediately. If we stop today, this burner, we couldn't stop climate changes in this way. This system will heat and this temperature will rise also by because inertia. And we calculated that will be up to plus 1.5 Celsius degree. After that, this global temperature, after half of this period, about 15 years, this temperature will go down slowly, and in the end of this period, we'll keep this temperature. But it is very important to build new system, new technology with this potential, and invest GDP, as I said, this reputation, and we in this way can keep this global temperature. We couldn't return temperature before pre-industrial level. We can achieve only in this temperature what we are today. And that's the way how do we see that we will be safe.
New technology. I'll explain shortly new technology. How we came to the new technology. Research integration system with solar system and hydro system. Solar energy is intermittent energy and couldn't get continuous energy supply. But pump storage, it can get continuous energy supply. And when we researched this system and developed mathematical models, we find a way that we ensure this intermittent energy transform in continuous energy supply. But it's very important that this continuous energy supply to now, to yeah, this pump storage, I'll say later, this pump storage can be seasonal energy storage and can get this, ensure this continuous energy supply throughout here. When we get, how do we go on idea to invent this new technology, to create new technology? We research solar power system in Andalusia in Spain, so-called direct steam generator. This system is solar system with parabolic through collectors. In the focus of this collector is a pipeline. This pipeline flows clear water. And this is system, many collectors send clear water through this pipeline, and we can get cold clear water. We'll heat it through collector 1, 2, 3, and in the several 8 collectors, for instance, we have high pressure separator who separate vapor or steam and water. Half of this heated water is vapor, half is water. And this vapor goes to turbine, heated vapor goes to turbine and generate and produce electricity. Today, it works in this way. And we said, why we don't let in sea water in this system? And that's crucial moment for this innovation. If we get sea water in this system, we'll get also in high pressure separator vapor phase, and we will get steam, and we can get electrical energy, turbine electrical energy, and brine water or concentrated water. That's system when we started with, when we created this innovation. In state of the art, this direct steam generator is developed in Siemens 1996. After 10 years, 2013, we patented this system with seawater. Not to be rich, scientists don't think in this way that we patented to be, the reason that we want to be rich, then we want to protect this technology. And this is system to show how it will work, that seawater will go directly through system. Comparison of two principle. If you say somewhere that you have radically new technology, you must compare to similar technology who exists. Steam engine is similar technology who can compare with new technology, seawater steam engine. What we have is see in steam engine. Steam engine is one input, coal heat. Inside of this system, it's not presented, is clear water, which is a closed cycle. Clear water in closed cycle. Here, operator goes to turbine, mechanical engine, and electrical engine. This is steam engine. What's new? We have new working fluid, another type. It's not clear water. Then, working fluid is in open thermodynamic cycle. This is seawater. So, working fluid is not present, but
This is working fully. So we have one input, solar or other, I'll show later, and we will get energy, as I show, and drinking water in the output of this energy. Breakthroughs. People want to, scientists want to speak always that they have breakthroughs, etc., etc. But there are not so many scientists who can understand what is really breakthrough. I know this problem and I show this. If you have some innovation, it's not breakthrough. It's an engineering principle. If you have an innovation, you are in an engineering principle. If you have new formula, you have in science. But if you have innovation, radical innovation, this pattern, something similar innovation, and some science principle, you can get that you have breakthroughs. Different set of science and engineering principles. It is very important that you have both of them. We show very shortly that we have high temperature over than 20 degrees Celsius degrees, 22 to 40, less than 40 degree, and in same time we need high pressure, about 80 to 100 bars. It is very interesting that up to now nobody researched what will be with seawater in this temperature and this pressure, high pressure. We have seawater with high pressure in submarine. We have up to 20 degrees with seawater, but with nobody researched these conditions, these physical chemical processes, evaporation, etc. What will be there? How it works is simple display, simple way to see how it's formed. We separated this picture in two sides. We have left side. This is solar thermal generator, what I said is Andalusia. Seawater goes up with the pump and the pressure with high pressure pump to solar collectors were heated, and this evaporated, half of this evaporator, half will be brine water. In high pressure separator will be separated. Brine water or concentrated seawater will go down. In brine, we can speak about this, but the vapor phase or steam goes to turbine, produce electricity, cold, cooling in the cooling tower, and water treatment technology. We can storage, or we can get drinking water for. We can store this for whole year to supply consumers to whole year. This is left side. Intermittent energy gets intermittent electrical energy. But what's pump storage for? If you have seawater, we need only one upper reservoir. We need upper and water storage is energy storage. We have upper storage when we can our consumer. Any consumer can use electric energy when these consumers need this energy. And always when need. This is stochastic value also. This is stochastic value also. But with this storage, you can balance summer surplus of energy, summer surplus, and winter leakages of energy, shortage. And it is very important, if we speak about renewable energy sources, we want to have seasonal energy storage. It is good, also smaller storage. This is smaller to this type of storage. But if you can get to your consumers continuously energy supply, you need pump storage. Bigger or seasonal energy storage, it is only one way if you want to get a great quantity of energy. It couldn't be small energy. We haven't so many batteries that you solve this problem. It is very important that you have big energy storage, bigger for this. And so, this principle. We developed, we derived two formula, we derived mathematical models, and we derived two formula, how to calculate it, how energy this system will get in the output, how many drinking water can produce. All of this value, this is input solar energy, output electrical energy, electricity depends on input solar energy. Also, produced drinking water depends on insulation or duration of sunshine. We have total annual energy production and total annual water production. We speak only about of total annual production because Earth in revolution repeated this climate for solar radiation in this case. We developed this model, this new formula, by dynamic programming. Who knows this method is very difficult, the most difficult methods for calculation, because it works very, very difficult in another way. And we developed this model, and in this model we calculated and got derived this two formula and published paper. We then not see what steam engine, because they didn't not publish our paper, but we said immediately see what steam engine. We said key engine in the first place. After that, now we can say that see what steam engine is open source to rest technology and start the third industrial revolution. This system, this new technology is not closed system. System who is closed and couldn't develop further. In input energy can be other energy, renewable energy sources. You can use other sources, mostly wind energy. If you have wind energy, you can wind energy produce electricity. Electricity will heat it. This core technology, we can call it core technology. And mine and other open source technology who can heat it and get energy input one, input energy in this system. This is working for it, it's not input. This is CO2. In the output of this core technology, other side of this core technology is also can be other technology. We said we prefer pump storage or hydro energy because it's the biggest one. This technology can today storage the highest quantity of energy. But you can use also other energy. For instance, in this Dubai, this you can get smaller energy storage and you can, for instance, hydrogen and use other technology. How we can understand, comprehend easier this technology? Like cogeneration. Cogeneration is a system that combines production, electricity, and heat. We have seawater steam engine, we produce electricity or energy and drinking water. This is a simple way to understand. And we analyzed research. We analyzed system in case study. Ireland is very good consumer for analyzing because Ireland is around this seawater. Alvis is in Croatia. Alvis is about 2,000 people in the summer, is 10,000 people. And we have data for this Alvis, this Croatia, and we published results here, and we get results. How many electricity generation capacity we need? 52 megawatts. Electricity production, 62 gigawatts hour. Water production, about 480,000 cubic meter per year, annual. And pump storage reservoir, 7 cubic hectometer. And land use for this system is 0.6 times 0.6 square kilometer. This is result for one island which could be quite independently from external energy and water, in drinking water, energy external and energy, drinking water, quite independent and quite sustainable, fully sustainable. When we go to Dubai, we think and we want to see what will be if we Dubai make quite sustainable. And we analyzed from annual statistics 2016 in Dubai Electricity and Water, Water Authority, DEWA, and we find data. Electricity generation capacity is about 10 gigawatts today. Electricity consumption, Dubai is 43 terawatts per year. Water consumption is about half of cubic kilometer. Seawater steam, if we apply seawater steam engine technology for Dubai, we have data, correct data for every day, etc., but we have this roughly assessment of data, and we make comparison and concluded that Dubai is about approximately 1,000 times greater than Island BC, Croatia. Very good. In this way, we calculated that there are 1,000 times larger system and 45% greater solar radiation than in Croatia. And we get electricity generation capacity is about 36 gigawatts. Electricity production will be 62 terawatts hour. Now is 43. It's greater than now. Water production for Dubai will be with this system about half of cubic kilometer per year. This is near to half of kilometer cubic what Dubai today desalinated seawater and get drinking water. But Dubai needs pump storage. These are what? Not 7 kilometers, much less, because Dubai has more solar radiation, and we haven't calculation for this. We think that could be about 1 to 2, eventually 3 cubic kilometers. And when use 90 times 94 kilometers. Carbon dioxide. This is current view of principle of sustainability, but we have new principle of green economy set this principle of sustainability. In this principle, you know, this principle that economy is in the middle, society is around, and environment is around. If you remember picture for the Paris Agreement, where I show heating of global warming, this is picture who show everything is in this picture. We have now high carbon economy changing in green economy. See what is the image set in green economy. About around of this economy is society. Society will change in third industrial revolution. I'll explain this. And environmental will be safe, or climate system will be safe. Scaling, this system can be large, can be small system. In future, large for cities, etc. Small system will be less. What's about costs? If you have, everybody wants to know, is this technology more expensive or is less expensive? We claim that it's less expensive because if we have two separately particular systems for producing energy, or in particular system to produce drinking water for 1 kilowatt solar power, for instance, you will pay more. If we have this system, total unit costs have to be less than from two particular systems. Why we claim that this technology can start third industrial revolution, and that this revolution will be the last industrial revolution? We are all ambitious. Why we say that same as sustainable community? I'll explain this picture in this slide. Industrial revolution. First industrial revolution factories built near to coal, because it's very difficult to transport coal from coal to factories. Just what is steam engine, and this is prime mover for first industrial revolution. In second industrial revolution, what we have in second? Displaced, dislocated, factories dislocated from power plants. We have power plants in one places, and in other places we have factories. AC polyphase system enabled this dislocation. And in third industrial revolution, we can get where is factory, where is settlement cities, etc., will be less. New technology will get this energy and drinking water. If we have two things, power plants, and you have consumers, factories, there are no other way to combine it. First way, combine. Second way, combine these things. And third way, there are no possible fourth industrial revolution in this way, because energy is this who drive industrial revolution. Oh, sorry. One slide. It showed this industrial revolution. This is only trend of innovation and compression to temperature and water. And we have in first and second industrial revolution, we have rising of global temperature. And we expect that new technology can start this third industrial revolution, and after that we couldn't emission high carbon emission and realize this policy and save planet.
As a part of CERPRO project proposal, we defined the financial aspects as well as the operational capacity for laboratory research. And we defined the time of implementation of the project to the stage of pilot plant. And the prototype of high pressure separator is created. Prototype of high pressure separator was constructed in cooperation with Faculty of Mechanical Engineering, University of Ljubljana, and company Ecomluce from Ljubljana. They are the partners of our CEPRO project. The prototype of high pressure separators showed that sensors for controlling of pressure, temperature, humidity, and two windows which we look inside in the separator and what's happened in the separator from the initial research. And it have a heater, one or more, and input of seawater and output of groundwater. Professor Glasnovic explained the breakthrough of our technology, and we need the determination of process parameters and physical and chemical parameters up to 200 degrees Celsius, and this is the new. This is the data for nobody research in the world. What's happened inside the separator? High pressure separator, working fluid is seawater, and we also use the water from rivers, lakes, and other polluted sources. In resulting vapor in high pressure separator, will be used for start to turbine energy production and obtaining drinking water. In our paper, we give the new formula, mass flow balance of separation process, and estimate about 60% of steam for efficiency our system. What we have done, here is the several phases. Some phases will done, some phases will still testing, and our it's working. Construction and testing of high pressure separator through the window, we look inside what is happened in the preliminary phases. Our colleagues from University of Ljubljana, Slovenia, determine the technical performance of high pressure separator prototype in laboratory condition, and this research described in master's thesis, analysis of experimental system for determining separator characteristics. In our results, testing of high pressure separator by gradually increasing temperatures and pressure, and data from research with compared with mathematical models. We know that we will have separation problems. The first problem is carryover. We need the dry vapor in the separation process because the vapor with carryover caused the problem with turbine and efficiency of this process. Also, the separation efficiency depends of correct construction of high pressure separator and water level in high pressure separator. Another problem is physical damage, damage to sealing surfaces, damage from lime scale. We will see that lime scale thickness about 15 millimeters caused the energy loss of 70%. And another physical damage is foaming, damage caused by organic substances or increased alkalinity of seawater. We must know the characteristic of input working fluid seawater, and there is the recommended characteristic of input water for different working pressure. For our technology, this physical characteristic, chemical characteristic, show this in the table, and also. If we have higher values of components, this is the cause the damage of separator or and turbines. Also, we must know the recommended value for characteristic in the separator, and that in the table show this. This value for working pressure. For seawater steam engine, working pressure about 60 to 80 bars, show in this table. Also, higher values cause the damage on turbine and separation process. Okay, in development of seawater steam engine will describe we will describe in several phases. In the first phase, we patented of our technology. In the second phase, we construct the and describe the laboratory research. And another phase is the real condition constructed the pilot plants for our technology. We also have a new patent to reduce the problem of seawater use this technology, because the seawater is very complex system and we know that we have many problems. And our vision of use this technology is floating city. This is the new, and we give the possibility that our technology applied with supply floating city with energy and drinking water independent of external sources. And Professor Glasnovich also gives the data for total energy production and total water production from our technology and the saving of CO2 of this technology. The most famous scientist on the world, Tesla, was born in Croatia. I hope that you know. But gentlemen, I have no guarantees. Expect my discoveries. I'm not an insurance company. You have to make me for my word and let yourself to your instinct, intuition, and imagination. And I show the beautiful picture. It is the river Cetina in Croatia. It's the beautiful nature. And finally, I will join us for forestall further climate change. We must do everything we can to save that beautiful country, almost no nature. Thank you for attention.